Hey guys, this is Abhishek from GadgetChoose.com and today we are going to do the unboxing and quick review of Jioni G2G Pad. Here we have the device with us and this device is an increment or an upgrade to the Jioni G1G Pad which you might have seen earlier. Now this is another phablet and if we take a look over the package, you also get a flip cover within the package and here are some quick specifications of the device mentioned on the box and the back side. So as you can see, it has got a 5.3-inch QHD display, which is an IPS LCD display, and the resolution of the display is 540x960. In terms of thickness, it is around 9.9 millimeter thick, which is pretty okay for a device like this. It has Bluetooth 4.0, 8-megapixel back camera, which is an autofocus camera. You have a 2-megapixel front camera, which is capable of doing high-definition video chat. And you have Android 4.1 Jelly Bean out of the box preloaded on the device, and you have 1.2 GHz Cortex A7 architecture CPU, and it is again a MediaTek CPU, and you have 1 GB of RAM, 4 GB of internal storage, and you do have a microSD memory card slot on this device to expand the storage up to 32 GB maximum, and then you have all the sensors mentioned over here on this device, so you can use this device for navigation as well. And the battery is quite large on this device, which is around 3000 mAh, which should be sufficient for a display size of this size. You have the MRP of the device mentioned, that is 17,499, and it is available at much cheaper price in the market. So let's open the package and let's see what we have in the box. Now as you can see here, we have all the package contents. We have the device and the battery is already inside into the device. We also get a flip cover within the package as you can see, and the quality of the flip cover is pretty good. As you can see over here, it has got a leather finish over here which looks quite premium, and the overall build quality is quite good, as well as we will show you the smart functionalities of this flip cover. And if we take a look over the pamphlets which we have got in the box, Jioni Android series pamphlet, we get the user guide for G2G Pad, we get a warranty card within the package, here is the information for the customer support in case you experience any problem, the service center address and the phone numbers are mentioned over here, which are spread across India, and you also get two screen protectors within the package. And let me just keep all these things aside. You also get the USB to micro USB cable, a standard one, and you get a 1 ampere charger within the package, a universal USB wall charger, and you get these kind of headphones within the package. They are not in-ear type, and again standard kind of headphones which you get within the package, and the build is quite okay, if not very good. And you do have a mic module and a button here to pick the calls. This is how the audio lead looks like. Again, quite nicely finished in terms of the build. So let's take a look over the device. And you also get a SIM ejection tool within the package of this device. And here are some instructions mentioned how you can actually insert the SIM and how you can remove it. And we will just tell you about that. Now before I start the quick review of the device, let me just show you how can you actually fit the flip cover onto this device. So here we have the flip cover which comes within the package, and the build quality is pretty good. And in order to actually install the flip cover, you don't have to remove the back cover on this device. It is a kind of a snap-on flip cover which you can place on the device, and you just have to make sure that all the edges goes right into the flip cover one by one, and this is how you fit it. And again, it gives a very premium look to the device. As you can see, there is a proper cutout for the loudspeaker, so the loudspeaker is not blocked. As far as the back side of the flip cover is concerned, you also get a leather kind of a finish at the back side, and the build quality is really nice for this flip cover. And again, this flip cover is not a normal flip cover, it is actually a smart flip cover. That means it will actually turn off the display once you flip the device like this. There is a proper cutout for the earphone, as you can see, so you can talk with the flip cover on the device. You don't have to open it. Micro USB port is also not blocked because of the flip cover. Here we see the 3.5mm audio jack, which is also not blocked, and the camera is also quite visible. There is no blockage for the camera or the LED flash because of the flip cover. And again, the volume rocker is quite accessible. One thing which I am actually not very much sure about the functionality of the power and sleep key, because if you have this flip cover on and if you have the device in your pocket, you might accidentally press the power button, which is actually visible from this side, and I can easily press the power button from here. There is no cutout for the power button over here, because otherwise it would actually affect the overall quality of the flip cover. I guess that is why they haven't given a cutout. But you can actually press the power button from here, and you might accidentally press the power button. As mentioned for this device, it has got 5.3 inch display, quad core 1.2 GHz CPU, Jelly Bean out of the box, and you have 8 megapixel front back camera, 2 megapixel front camera, and 3000 mAh battery. Let me just get rid of this plastic. As we already told you that this flip cover is actually smart enough that it actually turn off the display once you flip the flip cover on the device, and it will turn on the display once you open it up. So it is again will save a lot of battery, and it is smart enough to do this functionality. Now here we have the Xiaomi G1 G-Pad with us, and we have the next generation Xiaomi G2 G-Pad with us, and this is how these devices differ in terms of the screen size. So the screen size on the Xiaomi G1 G-Pad is 5 inch, and the display quality is not so good as you can see, whereas the display is actually much better as far as the viewing angles are concerned on the Xiaomi G2 G-Pad, as you can see. And again, the display size is bigger, the resolution is higher. You have a high definition resolution on this device, whereas you have a 480x800, that is a WVGA resolution on the Xiaomi G2 G-Pad. In terms of the overall look and feel, there again both the devices were in same color, but matte finish back cover on the Xiaomi G2 G-Pad. Although the camera which you get on this device is 8 megapixel camera, and you have an 8 megapixel camera over here as well with LED flash, but the overall design is quite different because you have a matte finish back cover, you have a glossy back cover on the Xiaomi G2 G-Pad, and again the mesh for the loudspeaker is quite big on this particular device as compared to this one. We will give you a detailed comparison of these devices later on. Right now we can show you this is how the difference actually looks like when it comes to the overall size of both of these devices. The placement of the power buttons has been changed, so you have a volume rocker on the left side on G1 G-Pad, whereas you have it you have a power and sleep key on the left side on G2 G-Pad, and this is how the devices looks over here. In terms of the thickness, they look like same. In terms of the overall thickness, the Xiaomi G2 G-Pad is around 9.9 millimeter thick, whereas the G1 G-Pad is also almost the same. If you actually compare, there might be a very little difference in terms of the thickness. The overall look and feel of the Xiaomi G2 G-Pad is actually much more premium as compared to the G1 G-Pad, as you can see. And again, the resolution is something which is quite exciting and which is making the G2 G-Pad look much different from the G1, as you can see. And there is a little difference in the display size as well, if you can notice over here. Although you do have the proximity sensors on both of these phones, so we will give you a detailed comparison later on. Let's go ahead and check out the Xiaomi G2 G-Pad. Here we have the Xiaomi G2 G-Pad, and the build quality of this device seems to be pretty good. You have a back cover which is glossy in nature, and it has some kind of a texture design inside. I don't know whether you can see it or not, but it is not that glossy which you see on other phones. Again, a kind of a premium look which I get on the back side of this device. Let me just give you a hardware overview of the device. First of all, on the bottom you have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging. On this side you have the power and sleep key which is quite accessible with your thumb and with your finger when you hold it in the right hand. On the top you have the 3.5mm audio jack. Here you have the volume rocker which is kind of above the edge on the phone, on the edges. And you have the 8 megapixel camera over here, which is an autofocus camera with LED flash. The loudspeaker grill is over here. And you have the touch capacitive buttons within the body of the phone. Here you have the earpiece, some proximity sensors over here. And you have the front camera, which is a 2 megapixel camera, which is a fixed focus camera. And let me just show you the phone from the back side. And before I do that, you also notice this chrome grill across the edges of the phone, which again gives the device a kind of a premium look. So it is kind of a phablet at 5.3 inch display size, which gives you quite decent features at decent price point. It will come up for a price of around 14 to 15,000 Indian rupees, and you can easily buy it from the market. And this is how the display looks like. And again, as you can see, the display is pretty good in terms of viewing angles. It's an IPS LCD display, so there is no problem with the display as far as the viewing angle is concerned. And it has got a QHD resolution, that is 960x540, and the display is not very crisp in terms of the formation of the text. You can notice a kind of a softness when it comes to the text on the display. It is pretty okay for a device like this. Let me just remove the back cover to show you the phone from the back side. You do not have any indent actually to remove the back cover. You can easily remove it from any edge over here, as you can see. So you can place your finger over here and you can remove the back cover. It can easily be removed from the device. Here you see the big battery, which is a 3000 milliampere hour battery. So the battery on this device is fairly large in terms of the overall backup and the performance. And you have two SIM card slots, so it is a dual SIM phone. The SIM card slot one accepts a micro SIM, where SIM card two slots accept a normal size SIM card. And you do have ejection tool over here, the SIM ejection tool. So once you insert the SIM inside this slot, in order to eject the SIM, you have to use this pin and you have to push your SIM from this side, from this hole, to actually make it come out from the slot. Also get a 16GB memory card within the package, which is already installed on the device, as you can see. Now here we have the device, and this is how the lock screen look like. You can easily launch the camera from the lock screen. You can unlock the device. You do have the time and date indication directly on the lock screen, and you will also have notifications as well on the lock screen if you enable them on this device. And if I just unlock this device, this is how the home screen look like, as you can see. So you have by default 5 home screens, and you can always increase and decrease these home screens. You can have maximum 9 home screens on this device, as you can see. So as you can see, this is how the notification center looks like, and you do have toggles for the Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, airplane, GPS, for the profiles, and also for the brightness as well. As you can see, the brightness, auto rotation, and power saving. So you can enable power saving directly from here. Let me just go to the settings to show you the version of Android. So the version of Android which is running on this device is 4.1.2, that is Jelly Bean out of the box. The storage on the device, if we take a look, we have 4GB of internal storage, out of which around 0.98GB is reserved by the operating system for the pre-installed applications and data. When it comes to the user available memory, you have around 1.74GB available to the user for installing applications and storing picture, videos, or any kind of data. You also get a SD card with the device pre-installed. So on the SD card, you get around 14.72GB for installing application, and you can always select the preferred install location over here. So you can install apps on the SD card as well, and we will tell you whether you can actually move the apps from the phone memory to the SD card later. And you also get the option of moving the apps to the SD card directly on this device, as you can see. This device has got 1GB of RAM, and right now 440MB of RAM is used and 537MB of RAM is free, and the device is fairly responsive. I do not notice any lag till now. When it comes to the display settings, if we check the brightness, you do have automatic brightness support on this device as well. When it comes to the wallpapers, you have support for the static wallpapers, live wallpaper, lock screen wallpaper, as well as you also can set the wallpapers on the settings and menu if you like to. Now when it comes to the audio enhancement option, I do not notice any audio enhancement options under the sound settings. So you only have simple silent profiles. I do not see any audio enhancement options within the sound settings. Now when it comes to the audio enhancement option, I do not notice any audio enhancement options under the sound settings. So you only have simple silent profiles. I do not see any audio enhancement options within the sound set. It does have GPS support as well, so that you can use this device for navigation whenever you want to. And for that, make sure that you check both of these options. Also, you need to check this option and tap over here and enable the GPO, EPO systems and the assisted GPS before you can actually start using navigation on this device. When it comes to the Android keyboard settings, I do not find the option of typing with a finger. Typing with the finger swipe thing on the keyboard, so you do not have that feature, the swipe to type with the fingers. And if we actually show you the messaging application, here we have the messaging application, and if we take a look at the keyboard, you have a pretty big size keyboard on this device. The keys of the keyboard are pretty big, so we did not face any problem as far as typing is concerned on this device. And you do not have the swipe to type feature on this device supported. Now this is how the phone dialer looks like, as you can see, and the keys on the phone dialers are pretty big. There is no problem with that, and you do have the option of doing a video call directly to a specific contact directly on the phone dialer. When it comes to the overall UI, the UI which I see on this device is little bit optimized. You do have this application called Theme Skin, which actually allows you to change the theme on the device. So you can change the look and feel of the device by applying a different theme, and you can always revert to the default Android look and feel and the theme which is there on the stock Android phones. It's now looking similar to the ones which have stock Android on the devices. So you do have support for the stock Android theme on this device in case you don't like the third party themes on this device. When it comes to the sharing of internet options, you also have option to share the internet by creating a Wi-Fi hotspot on this device. You have Bluetooth tethering supported and you also have USB tethering supported in case you want to share the internet from this device with the PC. These are some pre-installed applications which you see on this device, which comes pre-installed on the device. So you have a file explorer which comes pre-installed, you have NQ mobile security which comes pre-installed, you have the Facebook and Twitter application pre-installed on the device, you have Kingsoft Office, you also have some games like Asphalt 6, Little Big City, Texas Hold'em Poker and Shark Dash, which is again some of these games are not the full version game, but they are trial version game. But you also have One Clean application pre-installed, which will allow you to make your phone faster in case you are experiencing that this phone is actually slow. So apart from this, you also get a torch application, which will allow you to use the LED flash over here as a torch. And you also have the compass application over here. So this device does have a magnetic field sensor, so the compass is supported on this device. And if we just go back and show you some other application, you also have the system update application, which will allow you to update the software on this device, the Android version on this device, over there, so you don't have to connect this device to the PC, the version of Android on this device. Now here we have the hardware information of this device. So the model number of device is GPAD G2 and the product is from Jioni, and you have the ARM V7 processor which is clocked at 1.2 GHz as you can see, and it is a quad core processor. If we take a look over the display, you have 540x960 resolution, which is a QHD display, and the GPU is this PowerVR SGX 544MP. So it is again a MediaTek chipset with this GPU. And if we take a look over the sensors, these are the sensors which we have on the device. The 3-axis accelerometer sensor is there. You have proximity sensor, light, orientation and 3-axis magnetic field sensor on this device as well. And this is how the camera UI looks like, and you also have support for HDR mode as you can see. And right now we are in the normal mode. You have beautification mode supported on the device, and if we go over here in the settings, for the photo settings you can have a bus shot, 99 shot maximum. When it comes to the continuous shot, you do have support for self timer. The picture size is 8 megapixel maximum on this device as you can see. And if we take a look over the audio settings, you have the audio quality as fine. So that means you can record high definition videos from this device at 720p. It can also record 1080p videos, but that will be at lesser frames per second, as lesser than 30 frames per second. And let me just take a quick photo from this device to show you the performance of the device. And it does have tap to focus as you can see. So the photo has been taken, and this is how the photo looks like. In terms of the clarity, this photo is pretty good in terms of the details which I can see in this photo. This photo is again captured with artificial light in an indoor room, and the photo looks out to be pretty good in terms of the overall colors as well as in terms of the details. It is quite nice. Antutu score which we have got on this device is 9882, which is not a very high score, but again quite decent for a device like this. And this is how the detailed scores looks like. As you can see, the CPU has performed pretty well, whereas the RAM is a little bit low in terms of the overall score. And the score which we have got on Nina Mark is quite good, that is 49.0 fps, which is pretty decent because this device is capable of running the casual games like Temple Run 2, Subway Surfer, Angry Bird and Temple Run OZ as well. Whereas when it comes to the graphic intensive game, we have tried playing Dead Trigger, Frontline Commando and some other graphic intensive games like Need for Speed, and they run fine on this device. So as you can see, the browser on this device is again stock Android. I do not see anything new as far as any customization is concerned. You also get UC browser pre-installed on this device. If you are looking for a third party browser, you can always install Google Chrome as well. As far as the default browser which is there on this device, there is no problem with the scrolling. As you can see, pinch to zoom is quite fluid. There is no problem with the pinch to zoom. Double tap to zoom works quite fine as well. There there is no problem with the double tapped room, and panning is pretty smooth as well. And this device is also capable of playing videos within the web page. Within this particular browser, you can play YouTube videos which are embedded within a web page. You don't have to open the YouTube application for that. Let's try playing a YouTube video on this device, and for that let's load our channel. And for those who are thinking about the typing, it does give you a vibration feedback whenever you type using the keyboard on this device. And let's see, the video is right now playing on the device from YouTube, and there is no problem with the video playback as such. The video looks to be pretty clear, and the viewing angles are also pretty okay. As you can see, if they are not very wide, they're quite good actually. Playing this video in the high quality format, so the loudness of the sound which is coming from the loudspeaker is also pretty good. Now when it comes to Google Now, you can directly access Google Now directly from the lock screen, and for that make sure you are on the default stock Android theme on this device, and you can access Google Now on this device as you can see. And let's try the Google Now function. So as you can see, the weather,
108 degrees and clear in New Delhi.
So Google Now works on this device. Let us know if you have any specific question for this device. We would love to help you. You can leave them in the comment section below at the end of this video. If you like this video, you can click the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.